Hi developers, I'm Stefan Bertos and I would like to introduce you the new, brand new YouTube channel called ForDevelopers. In this video, we will reveal the idea behind this YouTube channel and key persons needed for this YouTube channel. So let's jump straight to the topic. This channel is a mix, or should be, a mix of informational, tutorial, live coding and entertainment channel. So it's gonna try to teach you some new, maybe old IT stuff, provide you some personal opinions on various IT development programming topics and more. It would cover the topics which I recommend for junior developers, but maybe also some stuff which is interesting for the senior guys or senior developers. I will hopefully not be the only one which would be creating content on this channel. And for now, let's say I would cooperate with my colleague Jiri, who is my friend and a boss in the current company where we both work for. And let's go into the details because I want to explain a bit about my working experience. So what can I say about the experience? When did I actually start? I think it was on the secondary school of electrical engineering, where we started with a low-level assembler on the 8080 clone. It was something like a calculator, where we had to manually translate the instructions to assembler and then manually program this. It was really a funny thing on the start, yeah, to learn. And then the next thing was a real PC, where we were learning the C language in MS-DOS, basic of algorithmization and this kind of stuff. Later on the university, it was, I think, Pascal, C++, Delphi, databases, I don't know, graphics, Linux, bit of neural networks in MATLAB, and as well some embedded systems like PIC and Atmel. On the LinkedIn profile, yeah, there is quite a lot of info. One was kind of a product which we developed for small cities and villages. Basically, it was kind of a search tool where you could search for law information. It was in Delphi, Windows Access, and it was more or less a client-server application with some GUI. So it was really a nice start and good teamwork. So the next one was a unique experience because it was a hardware and software development. So we were not only doing the software part, which was more or less on the embedded systems in C and assembler, but as well you would get your hands dirty with the wiring, soldering and so on. Yeah, so it was really nice to play around with the hardware and immediately see what it's doing when you program this. So very nice experience, which was with the, I think, Atmels and PIC microcontrollers. And the next one is the first job after graduating the university, which was a C++ programmer on the Unix, yeah, for the company called Printsoft. And that was basically a development job on the client server side, really on the hardcore C++ libraries on Linux, plus some small exposure to the front end for the Mozilla components. That was also a nice thing and fun. Next one, I wanted to try a big company like CA, and that was really another level of experience in some another world, which is not common to the most developers, and it's a mainframe, yeah. So more or less a development on the mainframe in assembler, where we were doing a strange porting of C code to assembler. So I will never forget this project, and that's all you can see in the technologies. Next one, again, a big company, but a different company, a banking one. And there I was hired as a junior software developer for the C++ part, again on the Linux, using some special libraries and frameworks. Yeah, so it was a nice experience. We had quite a long stay in Luxembourg, and it was really nice. Yeah, let's jump to the next one. Yeah, so basically I wanted to change again the technology stack going to Java, which was not possible at that time. So I again changed the company, and I was trying a small company, small Czech one company, and I was hired as a senior consultant, but basically I was a Java developer on the multiple projects at that time with various Java technologies, Java WebLogic, JPA, as well as some Oracle exposure, and so on and so on. Next one, which starts to get interesting because there is really a vast range of technologies and a lot of experience, where I joined as a senior developer again on the Java and related technologies, where we were basically, I think at that time, working with some older Java, obviously. It was JMS, AJBs, Flex, Adobe Flex, some web services, but as well starting to use Spring, Tapestry, old WebLogic stuff, Oracles, and so on. You can see it in this, you can see it on the screen. So then at the end, I was a bit tired, yeah, with the bigger company. So I wanted to go for something smaller, and I joined Equabank, which is a small Czech bank. And there I was again working as a senior developer on the front end and the back end, where the topics were bank topics, mortgage and cash loan, front end applications, integrations with the back end services. So basically the front end was in the Wicket, which is a strange framework, and back end in Juice, Spring, and technologies like this. And the last and the best one, obviously, is again to Logica or / CGI, which is the new name for the company, because it was acquired by CGI. And then I joined CGI on the pathway for the system architect. But it's not just like that. I'm doing a lot of other stuff. I'm still doing development, obviously architecture, coaching younger colleagues, leading the team, helping, coding when I have, presenting, and stuff like this, you know. Mostly the technology stack is around Java, Angular, Spring, other DevOps tools, then some clouds like Google, AWS, and a lot more, yeah. There's a lot more. I will not want to go into all of these details. So as you see, we have some experience, and hopefully we could enrich our subscribers with relevant content. So feel free to leave us comment, please subscribe, click on the bell to not miss any of the upcoming videos, and of course click on the like button. And that's all, folks.